Hi, I'm Ron Balicki. We're going to go into Kali Silat right now. We also refer to it as Ma Filindo Silat. Ma for the Majapahit, Phil, Philippines, and Indo for Indonesia. It's kind of a conglomerate or a compilation of all of those systems together. So what we're going to start with now is just basic entries, and then we're going to go into some throwing and then a little bit of the submission in it. So I'm going to bring Joe in. All right, we're going to go switch lead for me. All right, he's going to jab. On the outside entry, we parry, and I just want you to salute right here. So it's almost like the hand just comes up, almost like I'm saluting. All right, so he jabs, and then it's just going to come up right here. That's going to be our first entry. So as far as our entries, I want to categorize it as this. Outside entry, both hands outside. Split entry, one in, one out. Here, let me turn you this way a little bit. This is same lead. This is inside entry, and then this is gonna be reverse split. Now let me show you how you get into each one. So first one, when he goes, he jabs, that's gonna be my first entry. So I parry, and then this just kinda raises up right here. It just brings the arm over out of alignment. So if he's punching at me, if I can move his hand 2 inches, my head 2 inches, the blow misses me. So one more time, I just go right here. All right, that's our outside entry. One more time, right there. All right, split entry, I'm gonna actually swing you over this way. All right, split entry, when he jabs, it's just gonna go right here. I'm gonna go to the face. I'm still parrying like I did on the outside, but this time, I just let that hand come right inside. So one more time, that's it. So this is just gonna punch right up through here. Okay, that's the split entry. One more time, right there. All right, inside entry, when he goes, now I parry on the inside, and I stop that hand. They call it jam the gun. All right, one more time. So I go right there. I kind of try to hit that back into his face. One more time. It goes one right here. So far, outside, split, inside. Okay, now the last one that I want you to do is the reverse split. So now if he goes, I go right here. This is actually, I don't like to do it off the first hand. The second hand is what I like. So if you go one, and this covers, this goes right here. So this can hit this way. So one more time, one, and see how a hand shoot just shoots right from underneath it. I'm half in, half out. Let me do it on a lead. So it just goes right here like that, so the camera could see it, okay? So if he punches and this hand comes up, this one's gonna hit this way. I'll show you how it's employed in a minute, okay? So outside, split, inside, and split reverse. All right, so now we're gonna go into the jab cross series that I want you to do. He's gonna jab and he's gonna cross right there. So one more time, jab cross, right there. So when he jabs, I wanna go outside entry. That's gonna hit outside. This should wipe across the eye. Let me do that again. One, I wipe across the eye. This first elbow is gonna hit right here. So I try to pick off that tricep a little bit, just hit the nerve a little bit. It's not that you're gonna take your opponent off with a shot, but the way they look at it is every little shot weakens it or deadens it. If you look at the stick video that I did, I talked about defanging the snake. Now, if he were the snake and this were the fangs, I just tried to hurt a fang, okay? So we are gonna go one. That's the first elbow. The second elbow could be to the face or it could be to the bicep, right there. This is gonna knee, I step, that's gonna be the takedown, and this is the lock, okay? One more time. So he goes one, elbow, elbow, knee it. Now look what I do, I step, turn, and then this just gonna put the lock on right there. Okay, let me slow this down for a little bit, Let's swing sides too, okay? So, we go one, I parry, the salute comes up, I hit the elbow, lower that down, I can hit the face, or if I, let me do one more time, or if I go elbow and that arm's still there, they kiss it right there. Then they knee it, I step. See what I do? Important part. When I knee, I step and I bring the head with. If I were to knee and leave the head, it's hard to throw him from here. He's still strong, so I weaken the base. Now watch my left foot. I circle step, and I let him come right through this hole. Come on up, switch sides. After the salute, I elbow, knee, step down, step back, see where it goes. Now look at, I hold on to the tricep and the locks right here. This is what they call a gooseneck. Okay, one more time. Parry, salute, elbow, knee, step down, bring his head with. Circle step back, let him pull right through. See how he kind of funnels in? Then I come down, and then I put the lock on right here. Okay, that's our first one from the outside entry. Another one from the outside. If I did this first elbow right here, they just walk in right here. Now let me turn this way so you can see it. See, if I go right here, I go one. I walk here. See, this will go right like that, and that takes him down. Okay? So really, really slow. One. After I walk in, see, I want to hyperextend the arm right here. If I need to, this is a funny part, they'll use the chin. Can you see? Let me see if you can see the chin from here. Right here, they drop the chin, and then they just go right here. See, this is going to go and take that down. After they take it down, it's not over from there. They just go right like that, and they put the lock on. Okay? So, we go one, right here. See, I can walk and use the shoulder, or I can use the elbow. It doesn't matter. One, so I go right here, use the chin, just go right like that. Now I just come up, see, and then I just go down. That puts the lock right on it. Okay, come on, back up. Parry, salute, elbow. First one is elbow, knee, step down, turn, put the lock on. Second one, parry. You have a choice now, shoulder or elbow. If I go here, I go like that, that puts it down. Okay, step over, get back down here. All right, step over, and then you put the lock on here. Swing around a little bit for me. If you look, I base his forearm right here, and then I slide the knee right down. Yeah, that feel good? Yeah, that's pretty good. Okay, so I don't want to be sadistic on him. Yes, I do. But, so we go one. See, after I salute, if I come in with the shoulder, see the hyperextension to the arm? I could use the chin if I need to bend it. Then I go here. All right? He's got to do that jump, or he'll probably tear something. So we just kind of turn it over and then go right here. Okay, come on back up, Joe. That's the outside. Now, what it is I went outside on the rear hand. It doesn't matter. I could do the same technique to this arm also if I wanted to. You see it? So if I pull him over, and then I just go here. So it could be done right or left-handed. All right, come on. Split entry. So one, I'm going to go here. This is going to just punch right here. So one more time. One, I just pop right there. This is going to elbow. So after I go, I'm going to go on his chest. Like one, two, right like that. Okay? So after he gets the first shot, second shot elbows. Look at this. Can you see that? Let me turn you a little bit. That elbow kisses right into the face right here. So one more time. One, two, three. Then I just turn it this way. And look, we're back into that first one. Okay, one more time. One, two, elbow. I turn it down. See it right here? Bump. Then I just turn it. Okay? And then I could just grab it and go into the lock. One more time. Let me switch you around. Maybe you'll see it better. So I go one, two, elbow, shove it around, and then I go right into the lock. Last time. Elbow, shove it. There, now the camera can see it a little bit better. Okay, and all these are gooseneck locks. All I do is I just pick it up. What I am not doing to him is a lot of times they'll put the knee on the face and on the body, and then they lift, and then they go. Okay? So, split entry, right there. One, two, shove it, and lock it. Okay, inside entry I want to give you right now. One, so I'm going to parry and I'm going to hit. Okay, one more time. So I go, whoop, right there. Okay, so let me show you what I'm doing. This is called gunting. Now, I showed the gunting with the stick. It means scissor. They have it with the hand. So it goes one. See, it's like a scissoring motion. So one more time. One. See, they hit the bicep. Now, it's funny because there's some people that I've talked to and they go, it doesn't hurt when I hit it. See, little story behind this. Back in the day when like Gentleman Jim Corbett, John L. Sullivan, they used to fight like this. You've probably seen this in books. If you look at history books, they said during the early 1900s, the hands started to come in and they started to go up. And the reason being, a lot of the Filipino martial artists were knife fighters, and they couldn't knife fight with the knife out here like that, so they had it in. So all the skills that they had were here. So when they would box the same way. It came from their knife fighting. So this is the same thing here. When we go one, they hit here, because if this were the knife, they would just stick it. So let me grab this. You see, if he thrust at me, they would just go like that, and they would just touch right here. Let me switch knives, I'd probably see it better. So if you go here, pat like that, and they would pick it off. Or they would just pick off, I don't want to do it with the metal knife, but they'd pick off the hand, or if it came in, they'd pick it off here. It's the same deal. So when we go one, see, they hit here, and then they kiss the elbow up to here. So this, back to the old days, they used to shadow box in the Philippines. I guess during wartime, the military guys would sit there and they would box, you know, like army boxers, stuff like that. It's pretty famous, army-navy fighting. Well, the Filipinos would shadow box and they would start to curve their fist a little bit. You know, like they would go like that, and the Americans would look and go, look at that guy, I mean, he doesn't even know how to box. Look at him punching. But they didn't know what they were doing or what they were after. I don't want to kill Joe at this, but if you look at this, see, it hits the nerve. Got it. Also makes a bulge if you go in there, you can see that. All right, if you curve it a little bit, it penetrates right into there, and it doesn't feel too good. Okay, you okay? Mm-hmm. Okay, so if he goes one, see, hit the nerve, then they elbow. Now look at, I wipe the eye. Can you see that? I wipe the eye, go to throat, elbow, knee. Let me show all that again. Goes one, two, three, and the knee. All that's being thrown. So let's count it out. Parry. See the hit, see the elbow, see the eye, the throat, elbow, the knee. And then I'm back to the locking again. You see it? There's other locks that we do. I just picked this one for this video. So he goes, parry, binting, elbow, wipe the eye, go to throat, knee. See, this shoves it. See, and then I just go right to the locking. Okay? A lot of people think that Kali is just a stick art or a screamer, and they're really mistaken. It's not. It's much more than that. Kali is everything. If I had an art that I would say encompassed everything, or what would encompass not everything, nobody has the total answer. But I would say Kali is one of the most complete arts I've ever seen. They have everything from the handgun to the sword, double sword, short sword, staff, or they have flexible weapons, the whip, something they call the latigo, which is a flexible stingray tail off a real stingray. They use that. If you've ever seen Bruce Lee use weapons, a lot of that came from Kali. It was taught to him by my instructor, Dan Inosanto. And it's just very complete. It has a lot of different areas in it. It can look a lot at times like Tai Chi. It could look like Muay Thai. It can look like Pencak Silat, which is from Indonesia. It's very complete. And if I had something to choose, if I had to pick one, I probably would stay with Kali because of how complete it is. So whoever says it's just a stick art is very misinformed. All right, so going on. So now, we're back to the inside, right? I elbow, eye, right here, knee, push down, step, and then I just go into this lock right here. Okay, so if you look at this, just to give you an idea about the completeness of it, this is something called a sarong. Most of you probably know it. You see like girls in the hula, whatever, do it. But they wear it, right? I'm not gonna get into real deep, but I just wanna show you it. They'll sit here, and it depends on what tribe they're from, is how they wrap it. Some people will wrap it this way and they put a sword in here. Some people have a forward wrap where they'll wrap it this way because they're more from a kicking style, that way they can open it. Some people wear it long, or some people will wear it over their shoulder like a sash. This is kind of like the crescent wrench of the Philippines. They fight with it, of course. Not a lot of people know that, but they carry stuff with it, they dress with it, they actually use it like, unfold it and use it like a sleeping bag. Well, this is a last-ditch weapon for them. And the way this works is, I've already shown you, if I did the outside entry, right? See, right here? And then they just choke it out. You see it? So it's got a lot of purposes for it. They'll also wear it out here, single hand, or they'll wear it here like this, double hand. So if he goes one, I could do the same thing. One, two, grab, see, I shove it. Now look where I'm at, right there. Okay, so this chokes him out. So I just thought that it would be interesting for you to see that as far as some of the things that the Filipino martial arts incorporate. Okay, so moving on. So we had one, I wanna do the reverse split. So watch, I parry, and then it's almost like I just cover, almost like a George Foreman peekaboo. So if he goes one, I just cover up right here. See, this could hit, or I could just grab right here. See, all I do is just turn it over right from there. See, now we're just gonna go right here. Let me do this the proper way. Yeah, that's where I wanted to bring it. All right, so one more time. Swing you this way. So parry, and I just go right like that. This can be the uppercut, and then I could grab. Do you see it? This knee, see how I turn it over? And then right here, let me swing you over this way. Right here for camera, I just go right here. Let me turn you, there's where I wanna be. That's it, okay? So that's the reverse split. So far, we had outside. I gave you two for the outside. Then we went split entry. Remember, I kissed the elbow into the face? Then the inside entry with the elbow to the eye. Then the split. Now right here, I just turned it. I lay him down, and that goes right here. But what I want to show you on the split is this. Let me put it on this side now. So when he goes one, and I come here. Or I go right here. They pull the elbow, and then they're going to step this way. Now there's a lot in here. Let me explain what's going on. If I cover, they hit this up this way. Now look what they do with the bicep. They pull it. They slap in an elbow and then backhand. They just step right in. That's where they're going to go to the boxing if the guy's still standing. Okay, one more time. Parry. Cover. Kiss that up right there. So pull. And with the pull, ooh, I slap it. I used to think my instructor didn't like me because you go like that to me all the time, but you know, slap me in the face. But he wanted me to understand how jarring or jolting it is on your system. So we go one, I go here, one, pull, slap, elbow, step right in. If he's not down, you just go. Sorry, Jeff. Okay, so one more time. Here, uppercut. Just pull, slap, elbow, step right over this way. And then you're just gonna go with it. Okay, so now that's the sections that I wanted you to understand. So he goes, parry, cover, uppercut, pull, slap, elbow. I know it's a lot, but it's very good if you can get it down. It's very, go one more time. If I go here and say I don't get the shot, move, do whatever, see this upsets the system a little bit, or just kind of disorientating. So after I do the slap to the elbow and I wipe it off, it's hard to deal with that, man. If you just got like right there in the face, I don't know if you're gonna survive that. I don't know if I would. So if I'm lucky enough to get this far, I got a good chance to complete this. Okay, foot sectoring is another thing that we're gonna get into now. So we go, parry, cover, uppercut, pull, slap, elbow, step in, one, two, three. If he's still up, they pull this, okay? Or on the way down, let me just do it one time. When he goes, one, see right there, if I hit him, miss him, or whatever, when I pull and I slap, right there, now if you look the foot manipulation right here, what I'm doing is, here, step back. Right here, he's got a good base. I'm just gonna step out, all right. Good base. If I push him, he could pretty much hold himself up. Like, just stay stable. Just get in a comfortable stance. All right, now look at this. Obviously, he could bear into me. If I push him aside, it's pretty strong, right? Pulling forward is strong. If I can go one, two, and then hit that off, that cross step is gonna just kind of make his whole base pretty weak. So after I go here and I tilt him a little bit, this pull is not too hard to do. Okay, right now I've got to be nice with Joe, but they will kick it. So one, after I cover, I hit and I pull elbow and I step into here. That's really a kick. So they want to hurt either the ACL or whatever in here. They don't care about you, so they're just going to kick that right out while you're off base. You know, to me, I find it similar to, like, you see a lot of guys get injured being thrown because their leg locks, and when their leg goes over, their whole body twists and the foot stays there. It's the same thing here. When I kick that out, I'm trying to blow the knee out. You gotta be careful, don't hurt your partner. A lot of times when I'm training, I just put my foot there, and I know if I'm there. Of course, Joe, at this point, like, let me do it again. One, I go here, I elbow come here, and if I step, he can step out. I know he could do this, and we have counters for that. This is not about this right now. What I'm doing is later when I go here, and I step, this is not just a step, it's a kick. But all that weight here is gonna really stress out that knee, and you don't need to do that right now, okay? Right now, all I want you to do is just step in there. That shows me that I could get that, okay? All right, so now with that said, we're gonna go one, two, to the outside. It's a split entry again, just like I did before. But what this is a double hand throw. Now look at what I do right here. They drop, then they just kick that here, and they go right for the base of the neck. Okay, let me do that again. Now come on this side so you can see it from here. One, so after I cover, see this can hit it, or if I go this way, I could go from the outside, see it, and they just roll it over. This is gonna drop, they drop, then they move it over, and they kick the base of the occipital little bone right there, okay? It's kind of rough stuff, so be careful with your partner, make sure they're okay. If you're going with somebody who doesn't wanna be taken over that way, you're gonna step, just roll them over, a little more gentle. And then you knee, step, and that's the base of the neck. Okay, let me do that again. If I have to go here, and if I go with somebody that has a bad back or doesn't want to be thrown, let's go one, two, move it over, kick the base of the neck. You got it? Okay, so far we had outside entry, split, inside entry, sorry, reverse split. Okay, that's off the lead. It can all be repeated on the opposite hand. Okay, so now we're gonna go to the lower line. So Joe's gonna, let me actually put it this way. He'll be able to see. Switch lead for me. Okay, so we're gonna do a split entry. When he punches, I'm just gonna go right here. So this slap right here is, again, that gunting, and then I hit the face. So almost like a pinball machine. I'm gonna ricochet in, bonk, and then hit right here. You see it? So one hit. See, this is going right here. Let me show you how I did this again. Okay, so we go one right there. This weaves. Now check out my shoulder. I roll it over. They call this kobuk. When the arm takes the leg down in the Indonesian arts, they go one and they go here. Now watch what I do here. Sit. Yeah, that's the lock. It doesn't look like much, but you can look at Joey. Look at Joe. There you go. Uh-huh. Okay, so that's it. Okay, so we go here. It goes one. I go like that and I just go right down on it. Now look at what I do. Oh, right there. Look at my groin. Oh. Not my groin, his groin, sorry. So that after they hit this point, they kick, and then they step. Now this is where we're back again. Back up to the face. Okay, come on back over. So I go here, I hit like that. This rolls that. See, I kicked that up. Oh, sorry, Joe. Got it, didn't I? So I step, and then this is going to drop to the face and then run away. Okay? So one more time. One, two. Look at my leg. Let me spin you around. Actually, it'd be better if I spin you around. All right, so, one, switch leaf. One, right there, two. Do you see it? So now watch what I do. See how I took that down? Then look at this. See, then look at that. Then I just step over. See, I put my foot either here or here. A lot of people say, I don't want to put it there. He'll grab it. That's okay, they could grab it. And then you just go, okay? So one more time, this is called harimau. Harimau means the tiger. Okay, so it's a tiger system, so they go real low. So they go here, like that. See the shoulder hits it down? See, right there, step, spin, and down. And move this stuff out of the way. Come on back over here. That's the first one. So switch your lead. One, sometimes they'll hook it, okay? So if I go on the outside entry, they hook it and they just help pull it down. But see, now this is gonna set me right up to this position. So now right here, they just go right like that. And this puts it into the next lock. So let's move over a little bit. So if I go outside, I just hook. See, now right here, see, there's a lot, oh God, there's so many things that I wanna do. I wanna kick the groin before I step and stay here with the arm bar. This could grab the head, this steps, and that puts the arm bar on your opponent. Okay, so If I go out and I hook, if I don't feel I'm in a spot to get the groin, just step up with it. Hold this. Actually, what will help you is pin it down into the ground, grab the face, step over, and that's putting a lock on them right there. Okay? That's what we call a hari mao. Switch side. Okay, he's going to jab, and then he's going to cross. When he crosses, we scoop it. One, see how I scoop it here? One, two, and then you're going to hook it right here. Now I'm back to cupping the head again. Now what I do though is I step in, yeah, and then I pull it, and then I go down. That's the next one. All right. One, two, I go right here. This hits, sorry, Joe. Step through, and then I go here. Okay, one more time. So I parry. I'm gonna parry again with a little scoop. I hit it. I grab. Just step in right here. The arm will take him down. He's getting an arm bar placed on him right there. Then I just sit there and I squat into the face. Okay, one more time. Parry. See, watch what I'm talking about, the arm bar. When I step in, see, I'm covering this so he can't hit me. See that? That makes him want to fall. So as soon as he falls, I would just step to here and go down. When I do it with momentum, it'll pull him right between my legs. One, two, hit. Step right there. That's what I'm looking for. Okay? So that's the reverse split of going into it. So now, right from here, I want you to we're going to go into another section. This is going to be the arm drag down. Okay, so when he goes, he's going to jab outside entry, but I try to touch the shoulder. Whip a jab in and out. Whip it faster, faster. See, you try to grab a hand. Keep going. It's hard. I couldn't get that hand. It's too fast, right? So what will give me a half a chance of getting him is when he punches, I grab the shoulder. See, now I can slide down. Sit. Oh, and we're back here again. Let's switch sides. This is the arm drag down. So one, I grab the shoulder, slide down, just step and drop my weight, and I pull it. See how it kind of flip-flops him over? Then I step, and I put the lock on. Okay, one more time. One, I go here, in and out. There, see how I'm back at the shoulder again? Even if he isn't playing fair with me in practice, I mean, like, Joe, do a technique. If I leave it there, and it's helping him work the technique. If I go up to him, I go, go, Joe, do it. I can't get it. See, what he's learning is if he goes to the shoulder, he's got it already. I don't have to cooperate. And that's the way it's going to be on the street. Your opponent's not going to go, okay, here it is. You're going to have to go for it. So if he goes, I go like that. So if I can get to that shoulder, see what I do? I just kind of flip-flop him, and then I go into the lock. So one more time. He goes one, fast, fast, fast. One. So when I step down, my body weight tugs him down. Now, it's hard to do in slow motion to get him to flip-flop over, but my hand would pull and then pull. And if I do that in momentum, it'll pancake him over. Okay? So one more time. One, sit. So now I go up. Can you see that? And it flips him over. Let me do it again. Let me do it from the other side. I go right there. See how I got the shoulder? So I grab, pull, pull. Okay, there's no twisting of the wrist. All I do is I pull, pull. One more coming up. So one, down, pull, pull, sit. And then I just go right over. And that puts the lock on it. Okay, next section I want to go to is Kali. So now let me switch your lead, please. All right, so he's going to jab, and then he's going to cross. I'm going to do that outside entry. I want an uppercut. I've already done this for you. Remember, I grabbed the back of the neck. He's going to deny me that at times. So if I go one like that and he denies it, that's where I can bring you into the double neck throw, which I've already done. But there are times where I will not have the angle to throw. He's strong. I go, oh, man, I can't get him. So what I want to do is I want to take my hand off his head, and I want to put it on his bicep right here. And then I just drop, and then this is the lock right there. See it? It looks like he's free to get up, but go, move. No, it's kind of stuck there. Okay, so I'm going to do it from this side. So when he goes, one, two, I grab. He's not going to let me have the throw. He buried it. He's bearing into it. So I just change my angle, and I put my hand right here. This just drops. You see it? Then I put my knee in here, and then I hold this. If he goes to punch me, don't do that. And it's pretty easy to hold somebody and retain them. You might want to hold them for law enforcement to get there. You might want to just hold them because maybe he's, you know, out of hand, and you got to sit here and calm him down and talk to him a little bit. Okay? So come on, one more time. So one, two. I grab. I can't get it. I just go right here. I might not even be able to get the neck. See, I go here, and I go, whoa, I can't get it. And I just go right like that. And I just put the knee in, and I just hold it right there. Okay? All right. So that's the first one. The next one is, I might get it being the back of the neck. This movement goes here, outside entry, and they uppercut it. Spin the side. If you look, I might go like that. See, I cover my head, and I just uppercut right here. See, I grab. Now, if I don't like where the throw is at, I kind of push the arm over. See, I can just pop it that way. Now, look what I do. I take my arm, I put it in through here, and that puts the lock on. You see it? I'm going to spin you around. I'm going to do it from this side. It'll put you over there. So one. So when I go here, I go, oh, man, I don't like it. So one is I just push the hand back. If my hand comes around, see, I could do it on the high line too. See where I'm grabbing the tricep? And I just drop them straight to the ground. Okay? Let me put you on this side, Joe. So one goes right here. I uppercut. I grab. See how I spin it? I grab the tricep. I drop them. Now, good trick to this. If I push Joe's hand down and I try to push his head bare into me, he won't let me get it. Don't put his hand down. Put the head to the floor, then put the arm. He can't stop that. Okay? Very slowly. Parry. Come up. See the hit? The grab. Shove the arm past. Sometimes he might pull his arm back. See, if he does, you just pull it past. Then just step here. Whoops. And then he goes down. Okay? So we go in. One more time, parry. Sometimes I might not get his neck. So what I do is if he goes to punch, I can literally throw his hand up. No, I just go right like that. See how it shoves him down? Put his head down to the ground, and I put the lock on, okay? All right, so on a willing participant, meaning your training partner, when you train this, hit, grab, shove it up for now. Now I could slap it. Do you see it? And it takes him down. Put your hand through. Use your forearm down on his neck and press the hand to the ground. Let me give you an angle that you could see this better at. Let's go right here. One, two, see the uppercut? I grab. If he pulls it back or if I shove it back, I go right here. See this? I'm looking right at this punch. Be aware of it. So for now, I'm going to go here. I'll give you an answer for it in a second. Okay? And then the lock comes in. Okay. Time for the answer to that. Okay, so one. After I go here and I uppercut and I grab, now when I shove it, if I see that, they hook it. Look at what I do. Let me turn that. This holds it right here. So I just pull them down. This is a lock in itself, or one of my favorite things to do is to pull the head back and then just lock it right there. Okay? One more time. So let me put you this way so the camera can see it. One. See, I go here. So when I shove, I hook, I grab it. Okay? Okay? Okay, good. Then I grab it, and then I just put the lock on here. The lock, on a really flexible guy, I grab the whole throat. Sometimes I just put my fingers into the mandible. Or sometimes if he's so thick and I can't reach it, I put this hand in and grab my forearm and put the lock on. Okay, all of them are good. They all work. Just depends on which one you get lucky enough to pull off. One, two, three. If I see that punch coming, sometimes move. See, go for my chin. Hit. See it? It doesn't matter right there. See, I just grab it, take him down. Okay, grab, and then put the lock on. Okay? All right, so we go to the next one. One, now I already taught you this. If I grab and hook, remember that leg takedown? I go right there. Now I just go like that and put the lock on. See it? I'm putting a lock on his leg. I don't know if you caught that, but when I come through, let me go back in it. I just press right there. It doesn't feel too good. Does it, Joe, right? Nah, it's pretty bad. So if he goes, come on this side. One, here, right there, and I hook it. Okay? The uppercut doesn't have to be, sometimes he won't even uppercut. If he's more interested in pulling his arm away, I just go right here and I grab it. Do you see that? So now, watch my legs. I hook. See this? Now my knee goes in. Yeah, that's kind of, it feels horrible. Okay? Come on over here. Sometimes, when I go, he pulls his arm away from me and he'll get away. Now I just grab it. See, now I can just hook and go. See, yeah, I go right here. Sometimes Joe will kick. If he kicks, I just grab, pull it over, hook, and then I go into the locking right here. Okay, so let me do that again for you. So I go here, he pulls his arm away. See, I grab, hook, take him down. I put the lock on, but he goes, no, and he kicks me. I drag it, step, put that on, and then grab. Okay? All right, let me slow that down. All right, one, two, three. He tore his arm away, I lost it. I grab, hook my leg around his leg, turn over. This hits that nerve, he kicks me. If he kicks, cover your face. See how I grab this? I pull it right into my chest. Step over, this will go down. This will grab the face. It could grab the sockets or the hair if he's got it. If they did it to me, not too much hair up there. Okay, so last time, let me change the angle. One, two, he pulls it away, I just grab it. Hook, take it down. That's gonna put it there. Whoop, there, I go, no, gotta go right here. Okay, so that's the Kali section. Let me recap this for you. All right, so we had the outside entry or the jab cross, outside entry here. Split, it'll work on either hand. Inside or it could go inside, that's it. Or I go reverse or split reverse. Everything works off that. So if we go, I can go outside. I did the elbow, the knee. This is called, all right, I'm gonna give you two names, just for the heck of it. Okay, so this is called puter kapala. Kapala means head, puter means turn. So I turn the head, and then I put you into lock. Now, in the Philippines, they call it linakun or likus. Likus means, I don't know if you know when you're, I guess it would be mooring a ship or docking a ship, they coil the rope around the cleat, and that rolling motion or that twisting around it is called linakun or likus. And then the same thing, just put the lock on. Okay? All right, so the next one that we did was I stepped in. Now, watch, when I step in, they can jam the gun this way. Do you see it? Meaning jam the gun is I don't want them to punch me. They block it. See, they walk in, they hyperextend the arm here. They could drop the chin down in the elbow to get that bend. And then they just go right here. And then I walk them over, push down, and that's the lock. Okay, so the other way that they do it, I showed you two ways. One is they went here to here with the elbow to here, or other times they'll just go right here because they're blocking that hand and they try to hyperextend it with just the shoulder. They bend it and then they just roll it. Okay, and then we go here. Okay, next one, inside entry. One, I hit that. See, that's gonna be the hit right here. They elbow, wipe the eye, go to the throat, elbow the face, knee. There's a lot in that one. If you can't pull them all off, so what? But at least you have like little bits and pieces. And if I went and I got like a little bit of pain here, a little bit of pain here, a little bit there and there. Now, the wipe of the eye is magic to me. Yeah, I mean, I don't know how many times you poke one eye and you, with both eyes you can't see. So if I go like that to his eye, game's over, I think. I mean, I don't know, unless you're bigger man than me, I don't think I could take it. So if we go one, if I go here, whoop, like that. See, that's the wipe of the eye right there. Then I go throat and I go here. It doesn't have to be the throat, it could be the second one to the eye. It's not sport. I have to really stress that. It's not about being fair or cheap shots. It's full of cheap shots. Everything I taught you here pretty much is a cheap shot in some people's games or book. To me, I think it's beautiful. This art, the system, the way they put it together, it's everything is about winning. You see it? So everything just about that I didn't hear would probably be called in a boxing match. But it doesn't matter, we're not boxing right now. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Then I pop it over right here, and then we just put the lock on it. Do you see it? There's a lot going on right in there, okay? Then we can go one, the split entry. See, it just goes here, pat, right there. So I'm just gonna punch it. I'm gonna do your chest a little bit, right like that, okay? So it's not like it's a killer knockout shot, but you don't know what you're gonna get in the street. But if I go like that, then they go here. So I showed you this one first. Remember that? Let me turn you this way so you can see it. I wanna show you the opposite to it. One, what you've already been taught is elbow, elbow, and then turn it over, right? And put the lock on it, okay? The one that I didn't give you that I want you to have is after you do the split, I want you to pull. See the headbutt? Then I just turn, and now look at what I do. I push him over, and then I put the lock on, okay? Very simple. One more time. One, two, three. See, I could bump it up here too, like that. Then I just walk it over like that, and then I put the lock on it, okay? So from the split entry, you have two now. Here, here, and you hit it here. Or you go one, two, and then collapse an elbow. You see it? Now if I want, you see this elbow here? I bang it up into the jaw, and I just pin it right here. Put my hand on his elbow, hold his wrist. I stand it up. Don't be cooperative, stay there. All right, so when I go, I lift it, and then I push it back down. And then I just kind of turn over. Do you see that? Let me do it one more time for you. One, two, three, bump it up, turn, lift it up, pop it over, and then turn. Okay, that's from the split entry. Inside entry, I'll recap again. I just gave it to you, but I'll do it again. In, elbow, eye, throat, elbow, knee. I know it's a lot. Step, turn, there. You can watch this program over and over again until you get it right. So I'm going to try to show it slow a couple times for you. So we go one, two, okay, three, see I could kiss it here, turn it, bring it down, was the split, or the inside, almost the same, one, two, elbow, eye, throat, elbow, then I just go right here, I knee, step, pop the head through, and then I lock it up, okay, so that's pretty much a recap of the upper half. The lower half, let me switch them to here. When he goes one and I go in, that's called harimau, and I go right here. Okay, this would kick to the groin and I step. Do you see that? Let me scoot you in a little bit. So I would step right here. Then I go right to this position. Okay, let me do that one more time. Come on over here a little bit. We're getting way out of line. All right, one, I go right there. So what I will do is I let it deflect into the face. And then remember this position, I called it kobuk. It's an Indonesian term, it means the arm takes the legs down. If I did leg versus leg down, which is the harimau technique, this technique, they call it ledut. Ledut means the leg takes the leg down. Okay, so we go. One, and I go right here. Now this knee touches. Remember, Joey could kick me. I didn't have him do it from this technique, but I had him do it from another one. It's okay, I just pull it over. Hook the foot. Reach in and grab, or grab the ports and go in, okay? See, or if I go here, I just go one, I knee it, kick, step out, step over, and go on face. All right, so come on back. Okay, so now we went one. When he punches two, I hit here. Now this can go right into this position. Now I just take him down. And I knee it. Do you see it? So we go one, two. This would hit. Okay? One, two. They just hit it here. Now, they call this beset. Beset means to sweep. Like literally like broom sweeping. Is I step and I go right like that. And then I just put it on. The head can be raised like I did it. And they put that here. Or I could just put it down and go right there. Okay? So one last time, quarter beset. So one, two, hit. Just ooh, hammer it right in his face. Grab. I can grab the neck or I don't have to grab the neck. I could just step here and do it. If I grab the neck, I think it's a little more controlling. I like it. See, it puts his head right in there. Okay? So that was from the quarter beset. Now we're gonna go into the kari. I'll have him switch for this. One, I go outside. See, they uppercut. If I miss the uppercut, I can step in, do the double neck throw, which I've shown you. And then I go down. Let me do that again from this side. So he goes like this. One, So I just go right here sometimes. Step in, throw it over, and go down. Or I could just do it slow. If my partner had a bad back, I could still get my training in and just say, all right, just roll. There you go. It's nice and easy, and then you go there. Okay? So after that, if I go here, if I can't get the neck, or if he's real strong, I put my hand on the bicep. Just drop it right down. Then I just go right there. Okay? I wouldn't hold him normally. I mean, if it depends. I mean, your morality is going to bring it there. If it were wartime, I'm breaking and running. If it were like now on the street and somebody did something wrong, I'd probably just hold him and wait for law enforcement. So one, when I go here, I just trade to here. You see that? Doesn't look like much. Pull away. You see it? Then I put my knee in there and I just hold it right there. Okay? But let's say I get it, I hit or I miss it, and I grab. Okay? Now if he's strong, he's gonna lock out. I have a choice here now. I can go back to this, which I've already shown, or I just pop that up. Do you see it? Always aware of what this fist is doing. You gotta be ready for it. Sometimes if you feel it's coming, sometimes pull back down. Other times he might try to come in and throw me also. So you see where I'm at? And then he could take me. Be aware. You know, it's a game of chess. You gotta go, and if you gotta try it. If you mess up, he's gonna get that. But right now, when I go here and I try to hit and I grab, and if he's strong, I pull it, I just pop that right there. See it? Now, insert your arm, push the head down, push the arm down. Okay, come on back. Okay, let's step over a little more. But when we go one, sometimes my hand will stay on the head. I just re-grab on the high line. Now I drop my way down, push, and that puts the lock on. Okay? Sometimes when we go and I go here, I could pop the elbow. Sometimes they'll pop the face also. If I don't like that, I grab through. Do you see it? This is horrible because he cannot break fall. So I can nosedive him, and if I want to, not hold his weight, and he crashes in the ground, he could damage an arm. Now watch, come on over to his head. I pull the head back, put the hand in, and that's the lock. Okay? All right, come on back. So one, two, up. I grab. I go through. Say he pulls that arm away. It's okay, because I still got this arm. The same thing. Okay? We also have it with the Harimau incorporated, that leg technique that I showed you. One, two. I can grab it and hold it and take this. You see this right here? That's it. See, his only defense now is really to kick me. If he kicks me, I just go like that and I pull it over. I wrap over and take the neck. Usually, this press raises the head, which is good for you. Okay, sometimes they don't feel it. Not everybody has the same nerve, like pain capacity. I've done to some guys and they go, I don't feel it. But that's okay. It's all right. If they don't feel it, just grab, pull, and then go. Doesn't matter. Okay, sooner or later they're gonna feel it. If A doesn't work, press the B. Okay, so coming over. If we go, one, two. When I go in here, if I lose that, pull it. Yeah, thank you. I hook it and I can do the same technique. There, he kicks me. He doesn't want me on there. So I pull it over, hook it, come up, grab and take the lock. Just train it. Like I said, you got this program. Just keep reviewing it. Go over and over and over it again. And I'm sure, like myself, with my instructor, I've watched him do it so many times. And each time I watch, I go, oh, and I pick up something a little bit different. Give it a chance, kind of empty your cup and, you know, just give it a real good look and try it out. I think you'll find something in there of value.